I'm good. How are you?
I'm good, of course, and I so can see how happy you are because there are a lot of reactions that you are getting, a lot of reviews are pouring in because the show is on now, the show is live. So what kind of reaction you are getting basically?
I'm getting a lot of love, more love than I thought I would. A lot of people are relating to it. A lot of people are finding artistic value in it, which is great. But and a little pocket of people who don't get it, and that's okay. It is art should always have extreme reactions. Art shouldn't be, it was nice. We don't want to be nice. We don't want to be okay. We want to be great. You can love us or hate us, but don't be say we are okay. So I think I like the extreme levels of reactions that I'm getting from people.
That's cool, but I have to say that like I finished watching it because I had to finish watching it before I do the interview, right? So I'm like, bro, this is so complex. Tell me one thing, and because I also watched the film Cake right before, like when the film released. So tell me one thing, that why do you have the fascination to tell story in much more complex manner than usually it happens in the mainstream cinema, especially in South Asian storytelling, if I talk about especially.
I guess maybe because I've studied film and my background is in film theory, so I think I almost think of films as texts that you read and you kind of reread and you analyze and you write about and you rewatch. So I think that's why I do a lot of research into the topics and the themes that I'm covering. The idea is always to, for people to come back and say, "Hey, why did he do that?" And I want to know and start researching those things. So whether it is, a hidden painting somewhere which has a message, or it is, something or the other that is always trying to communicate beyond of obviously the actors.
The casting of the show, I have to talk about that. So interesting. And after I watch it, after like I finish watching it, I'm like, dude, I think the Pakistani film industry, film and television industry might just feel intimidated by the talent of these actresses that she, the way you have explored. So I do not know like how they are gonna get more offers from films and television shows because they are so good actresses, man.
Thank
Like,
you. Yeah, they worked very
damn.
hard. They worked very hard, and we had a and they well, they're phenomenal actors to begin with, but they also, it's art and then it's craft as well, and you have to nurture that craft. They put a lot of effort. They gave me months of their time in prep. Not most actors do that. And they came in, they were doing readings, they were doing session one-on-one sessions, they were doing rehearsals. So that's how you kind of build character. It becomes a collaborative art form then in that case. And I think that's why they really became those characters for those months that we were shooting this.
Okay, there are a lot of things that I would love to talk about, but of course, I do not want to give away the spoiler. Otherwise, मेरे ऊपर जूतों की बरसात हो जाएगी. वो नहीं चाहती हूँ मैं. लेकिन लेकिन tell me, I want to know like how did you approach Mahira to do that special appearance?
I just approached Myra. I just thought that someone, it was just a cool, a godmother kind of a role. And I was like, who's the godmother of our industry? So I was like, I reached out, and luckily very, very kind of her to agree and be a small part of this.
So, would you like to also in future would love to collaborate with her for some projects?
Of course, I think if the right opportunity, the right timing, so many things are at work, right? It depends on the fit of the character, it depends on the story, depends on where she is in the trajectory for her career. And also, Myra is a very, very busy individual. So, but yes, if the stars align, I would love to.
For sure. Another very interesting part of this whole show is it is streaming on an Indian OTT platform, right? So tell me, was that one of the reason for you to feel excited that it is, firstly, it is a OTT platform, so there are a lot of freedom that you get otherwise you do not get in television and films, and also there is a different level of relatability when it is shown to the Indian audience and Pakistan, like South Asian audience, right?
Yeah.
So was that one of the
it worked on, we were just talking about stars aligning, but this is a pure example of what happens when stars align. When like Shailja reached out and Z5 came into my life, the whole idea was that this would be done in a way that I would maintain my voice, I would maintain full creative freedom, full creative liberty, and the show would not only be relatable to India. Of course, that is a given because we have so many shared realities. We have so many shared, cultural understandings. And, you know, both the women, both countries are face different kinds of oppression. So there is that connectivity that India and Pakistan have. But beyond that, Z5 was presenting this in hundreds of other countries. So yes. I think the narrative of the narrative of female rage that we have in this show, it's a very, very global topic. It is very globally, people know that when you keep pushing women in a corner, they will at some point be some kind
after
of
after a right point side. Of time, yes.
Yeah. So I think that was really important, and I've been very blessed, to be given that opportunity by Z5 and to be presenting this in Pakistan, in India, in like 190 other countries. So it's been great.
Yeah. As a storyteller, when you are telling the story of women, right, and so far that's what you have done. What kind of responsibility do you feel as a storyteller? Because you see, when you are writing a book, the person who is reading the book, it is a given that the person has that much material in their mind to understand. When it comes to the visual medium, now it is a different ballgame altogether, and the picture says like creates like much more impact, and we all know that.
Yeah.
So when you are telling story using the audiovisual medium, what kind of responsibility do you feel as a storyteller?
That's an interesting question. I think I am, I do feel partially responsible. And for example, in this case specifically, I was telling a female story, like you said. I wanted to appear as an ally. I did not want to appear as someone who was wrongly communicating a woman's issues or a woman's troubles. So I had female script consultants on this. I had female ADs on this who were helping me navigate my storytelling. They were good soundboards. So I did feel that I had to do justice to their stories. But do I feel responsible in giving a morally correct judgment call? No, I don't. Because I feel I am a storyteller. Like, just like a book. Or, the idea is that the audience is smart enough that they do not want to be spoon-fed, that they know after decades of watching film and cinema and television how to decode the material. So when you get something, for example, if you see a character smoking, that does not mean that suddenly you will start lighting a cigarette or you will believe the cigarette is right. So I do not feel that I need to show characters that fall in a box of morality that is okay with most of the audiences. What I feel responsible is that I need to tell the story authentically. I need to be my first loyalty, my first responsibility is to the story, and first responsibility is to my characters. Okay, only later on is my responsibility to the audience, and that responsibility is, to be honest, to show stories that resonate with them, that are cathartic, that give them a new perspective, but not necessarily pass a judgment on that story.
But Asif, at the same time, when we talk about real story in a realistic manner, which at times toxic, at times heart-wrenching, is our kind of story, our kind of excitement. But isn't it, entertainment is also for escapism, as a form of escapism. So then if we are watching the reality that we are living also, like if we are watching the reality on screen that we are also living, so then are we also like, kind of serving that part of the form called entertainment where it is also about escapism?
I sure, but it is, you know, you do, it does serve both purposes, and not all content has to serve both purposes. So if you take just Bollywood, you have a lot of escapist cinema, you know, a lot of the mainstream big glossy cinema that you would say is escapist cinema, and a lot of indie cinema is more realistic. Now, you know, that does not mean that the realistic cinema is not entertaining. Of course, you need to be entertaining, but you need to have that connectivity as well. Like, why did a film like Badai Ho do so well? Why did it resonate so well? It was a very realistic story, but it was done in a very entertaining fashion. Same thing with a film like Queen. It was entertaining, but it was realistic. I think audiences have moved away from Switzerland and trees and wet saris. And, you know, it you know, all of that has kind of, you know, moved on. No one wants that anymore. And that is because audiences' taste and aesthetics and sensibilities have changed over time. So I think web series, yes, the content that I've made in Churel, it is more realistic, but it's also a bloody thrilling ride. I mean, you know, most people who are watching it are binging it because there is a suspense. Who? What happens? What happened? What happened to this person?
Scratching your head to figure things out. Yeah.
I think that it's the mix of both things. For me, that's important. For me, it can't just be me. My content can't be an escapist content. Just like, for example, I don't ever see myself doing an actual superhero. For me, these are my superheroes. I don't see myself doing a fantasy superhero film.
Somewhere intertwined, right? The painful past that we have between two countries, and the admiration that we have for each other in terms of art, culture, and music, right? We all love Noor Jahan. You love Lata Mangeshkar. Like, you know, that things are there.
Yeah.
How do you look at this whole thing of the way politics is always, you know, kind of putting us like, you know, pitted against each other? And what do you think then the role of art and culture should be?
I think the role of art and culture should be to facilitate what politics is not able to facilitate, which is building bridges and dialogue. You know, that is what is happening right now. For the last 2 weeks, I have spoken to, you know, 20 plus Indian journalists who are sitting in India. I am sitting in the UK, but I am Pakistani. What are we doing? We are talking about art. We are connecting. We are connecting through the medium of storytelling, which is one of the oldest forms of entertainment. You know, people used to gather around fireplaces and tell stories in the olden times. You know, it's the same thing. It's the same thing, but now done on a big screen or done on your laptop. So whatever
digital
the case
platform, kuch bhi hai,
Magar, the point is that it the reason for that was to bring people together. Okay, and that is the purpose of art. That is the purpose of storytelling, and that is what our purpose is. What will keep happening, what has happened historically, and I hope it doesn't happen, but may happen, is that institutional politics will keep coming and fingering, and perhaps the exchanges stop for a bit. But it is like a magnet; it will keep coming together. It's, if you take the history, you separate us, we'll come together. You separate us, we'll come together, and it'll keep happening because our agenda is different from that of politics. It is not to divide people. It is not to spew hate, but it is to find stories that connect people. And these stories, and the story that I've been telling, and whether it was Cake or Churel, I mean, the amount of love I got from India after Cake was phenomenal. I still have people, more from India than any place else, because Indians write to me almost on a daily basis because they've got Cake somewhere on a digital platform and seen it. And so I feel like these stories transcend all that politics and all that ill will that other people might have, because he'll say, "Acha, zindagi aur maut, humanity, jis tarah connect ho rahi hai, wo wahi cheez hai. Aurat wahan jaisi hai, wahan yahan bhi hai." So I think that connection is much more important than politics.